My name is David Swope, and I am the manager of student diversity and inclusion at College of DuPage. Part of my responsibility is to make the college a relevant place for all people. And that's one of the reasons why you are here, so that you can identify with College of DuPage as a place that's culturally relevant, where we ascribe to or we strive to teach and to learn from a mechanism of cultural awareness, social understanding, unity, and the concept of belonging. So our theme for this particular conference, for the 2019 Black Student Leadership Conference, is our stories, our voices, and our journeys. And we want to encourage you all to listen attentively. Take notes when you hear things that's interesting to you. Engage in all of the sessions. Ask questions. That's the best way to learn, is to ask questions. And then when the opportunity presents itself, spend some time talking to the representatives that are here. It's our goal to have HBCU representatives here today. And we're looking forward to that opportunity with the schools, as well as you all having that chance to engage with them one-on-one as much as possible. And so for the sake of time, I will introduce the keynote speaker. We will bring her up and let her start her presentation. So our keynote speaker for this morning is Dr. Chandra Gill. She is energetic, enthusiastic, authentic, a woman of integrity. I know this is not on the notes. This is just what I know of her myself. She is a scholar and a motivational speaker and an advocate for education of young people. As a sociologist, Dr. Gill established Blackademically Speaking to help solve the educational crisis in America. As an activist, Dr. Gill has exposed over 1,000 youth to opportunities at various colleges and universities. Dr. Gill was inducted into Phi Delta Kappa with honors, high honors, after receiving her PhD in Educational Policy Studies at the University of Illinois Urbana-Champaign. As an esteemed educator, Dr. Gill is regarded as one who simply knows how to teach, while touching the hearts and opening the minds of students everywhere. Her Champions Break Chains tour successfully reached 350,000 students, teachers, and parents throughout America. Her more recent release, Black Genes, Black Genius, a motivational handbook to empower Black youth, is her answer to what she labels an attack on the intellectual and cultural genius of Black children. Her current History, Healing, and Hope tour, geared toward culturally empowering Chicago's children, is gaining a motivational momentum, serving thousands of students in some of the city's most blighted, violent, and undeserved communities. She is very highly motivated with what she's done. And so, she is here this morning to share her story, her voice, and her journey. Why don't you make a round of applause as we receive our keynote speaker, Dr. Chandra.
Mrs. Bridges, are you personally aware of prejudice in Birmingham?
Well, of course, I guess there's a certain amount of prejudice, but I'm not aware of there being much prejudice. Nothing like the people of the North seem to think. Among my friends, we don't seem to have any particular prejudice.
Oh, Self-evident that all men are created equal. I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slave owners will they be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. I have a dream.
16 shots. Y'all heard it. I'm from Chicago, so I came to be real for the next few moments. 16 shots, you heard it. We're coming real this morning to kick off this entire conference. 16 shots. I was on air, Dr. Chandra Gill, Talk of Chicago, 1690 WVON. And while I was on air, right after I got off, anybody who have ever been in a production room, on air, or in a studio, I had to debrief with my producers, and my producers say, Dr. Gill, this caller said that, we like this, we like that. And as the callers and all of that was being debriefed with my producers, I get a call on my phone late that night. I'm jumping right into the premise of my point this morning. Don't get it twisted. I'm here to be real with you. That call was a call from my aunt because my cousin was laid up in a hospital, 16 shots. That's not my cousin. He got four. I'm coming here to tell you today, I ain't here to play no games. I'm here because I believe in each and every one of you en route to the hospital. En route to the hospital. en route to the hospital, I had to drive from 87th Street all the way downtown to Northwestern, because see where I'm from, they are just now getting these treatment centers for trauma. So when you're shot on the south side, you got to go way to another side of the town. Can I talk to my people today? So I had to drive from 87th Street while I was on air all the way downtown. And let me expedite this, because we ain't got a lot of time. Y'all got to get to y'all sessions. When I got there, my cousin, can I be real? Can I be real? My cousin's brother, who was there as well, he said, this is what happened, such and such, such. I went straight to the doctor. His mom, my aunt, she said, Chandra, Tay been shot. So we're still trying to figure out if it was four bullets or he just had, because he had four holes. And we don't know if one bullet caused two holes, meaning one came in. We can't figure all of that out. But I'm starting there today because for me, this is real work. I'm not here to epistemologically break nothing down, methodologically show you my PhD, sociologically assess, or none of that. I'm here to be real with you all. Yeah, I got a PhD, but I'm here because I am wanting each and every one of you to see the severity of this time. I ain't here to play games. Posit that in your mind. While I was speaking one day, I got another story. While I was speaking one day at a banquet, I was asked by the community college in Chicago to come and deliver a keynote address. I get there, and I'm sitting there, and I'm doing my thing. I don't know, God always uses me in an important way, I guess. While I'm there, I meet several people. I'm signing books. I'm doing my thing. I leave. It was a good engagement, so I thought. Afterwards, I get an email. The email goes like this. Dr. Gill, I just want to thank you for your words today. I wasn't going to come, but something told me to come, and no offense, I didn't know who you were, so I wasn't going to come. I heard you were highlighted, but I also heard they were giving away free food, so I came. She came for the chicken. She ain't come for me, she came for the chicken. See, y'all missed that. We got a thing for chicken. But anyway, I don't need it. Toward the end of the email, students, she said, and as I was there, I was about to leave with my free meal. She got to the back door, and in her email, she said, something kept telling her to stay. So she stayed, and she listened against her will. And at the end of the email, she said, I just want to thank you, because I was actually about to take my life that morning. You said something that inspired me to live. I give you saved my life. I come today for the next few moments because I understand that everybody that's sitting here got a story to tell. Thus, the theme of this conference. We all got a story. And so I got a third story before I get into the PowerPoint. Because I got to tell stories. I promise you I'm pretty good at this, so I'll come back and have it all make sense. I had a young lady, another young lady, she said, she told me a whole story. Sometimes people meet me and they want to tell me their whole story. Like when I was two, I was, and then they want to tell me their whole story. She told me when she was 12 years old, she had her first epileptic seizure. Raise your hand if you know what epileptic seizure is. Epilepsy. Fall out, you lose all your vitals, it can be neurological. Nonetheless, she said that she had a series of seizures during her years. And in her adolescent years, she was told that she may never drive and that she may never be able to swim in high school and take swim class. And she went on to high school anyway. I want you to hold on to that because I'm looking for some students that's gonna do it anyway. So she went to college, and with all of these impediments, she was taking 3 to 6 pills a day. And she said that she always had to fight the odds growing up in the inner city. And she said that she kept doing it anyway. Her first year at the university, she said she didn't do too well. She suffered from serious migraines. And in those migraines, she had to withdraw her first semester. So she came home and she said she got herself together. She went through a series of tests and the doctor said that your tumor is actually growing, which is what we think are causing your seizures. So we actually may need to go ahead and perform brain surgery. Her parents got together and her parents said, oh, not on my watch. We know a different kind of doctor. Y'all ain't ready. And that doctor is gonna take care of this. That student went on back to college and the professors told her, you will never be a full-time student. Watch out for people who tell you what you will never be. You got some proof in the pudding. So in that, she went back. She didn't do well. She was on probation. Now, mind you, this was an honor student who had a difference, not a disability. Just had a little difference. And so she went to the university on probation her second year. And that student somehow got herself together, digging into her bag. She found a way to academically achieve again. We'll come back to that story. Today, I want to ask you a couple questions. And if you're smart, you're going to take some notes, because there's going to be some good stuff. Don't start digging now. The question is, with that student who went on to achieve in school, I wondered what the professor thought when he told her that she would never succeed because of her difference, not disability. The question I'm going to ask you today is, what do you what? I don't hear y'all. What do you what? What do you what? Who peeped how I did that? The letter C. Who know what a homonym is? Come on, holler at me. What's a homonym? Words that sound but a spell. Okay, y'all ready? Y'all ready? She like, don't ask me. Do not look at me. She like, I sat back here for a reason. What do you see? What do you see? That student went on. She went on despite the professors who told her, despite the doctors that said it wouldn't be possible. That student went on to get her degree. She did not get the surgery. That student chose to stick to her guns and did everything that she could. She went on, as she told me, to get a bachelor's degree in sociology. She got a master's degree in educational policy studies, stuff you ain't never heard of. She got a PhD in educational policy studies with an emphasis on policy analysis. That student is me. So if you ain't careful, 6 pills a day. She was like, I was already on it, Dr. Gill. I was already on it. If you ain't careful, you will judge somebody by what you see without really seeing. And so today I'm coming to drop a few jewels. Don't be confused by what you see. Everybody got a story. You can't sometimes see determination, but it's working. You can't see motivation, but it's working. You didn't see epileptic seizures for 20 years, taking 6 pills a day, getting over 200 pounds, but that was me. Now look at me now. I'm coming here today to talk to some people who want to prove some people wrong. What do you see? We got to jump into it. The first thing I want you to see, people, I'm about to use these seeds for you to see. Oh, y'all ain't ready. College and career readiness. I want some people in here to understand that you got to start creating the life you want right now. You have to create this whole notion of college and career readiness. If you want to go to Harvard, act like you want to go to Harvard. If you want to go to Spelman, act like you want to go to Spelman. But understand that Spelman got requirements, and one of the requirements ain't got nothing to do with hanging around people that's going to pull you down. One of the requirements of college is not to be around people who think you all that because you get good grades and they get bad grades. I'm going to get back to that. I need for you to create the life you want and deserve. I want you to also create, don't just consume. I'm so sick and tired of us standing in line to buy gym shoes and we don't make them. I'm going to go over here because I just lost some friends. Come over here. They like, dang, but the joy's coming out. Create. Don't just consume. Create. I need you to go look up Tulsa, 1921, Black Wall Street, when we were the bankers, we were the doctors, we were the attorneys. I need you to create. Stop just buying everything. Create it. Don't be looking for the next video game. Create the video game. Don't just play games with people across the world. Build games for people across the world. I need you to see college and career readiness in a whole different light. I want you to go to college. I want you to have a great career, but I want you to create that. I want you to use your imagination, and I want you to get to a space where you understand we come from a legacy of creators. That ironing board you use, a sister helped improve that. Think about the things you got. Look at what you got on. Look at what you got on, people. What you got on? You got on somebody's idea. Somebody sat and said, we want a sweater that looked like this, a pair of shoes that looked like this. What can you give the world? What can you give the world? Say it with me, college and career readiness. Y'all sound real lame up in this piece. College and career readiness. I need you to create. Say create.
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 Okay, all right, y'all ready? The next one, I need you to do what? 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 I need you to think about some stuff. One of the biggest problems you have at your age is the same problem that a lot of people at my age have. They have not learned to let people go that ain't good for them. I'm gonna go back here because you're like, but we was on a swing together, Dr. Gill. We was in third grade though. That's really like my sister. You can still be her sister. One of the hardest things to realize is that everybody can't go with you. Just because you all grew up together don't mean you're gonna go to college together. And that's okay. I have a relationship formula that I use. If people don't add to you and they subtract from you, they multiply your problems and divide you from the one who created you, you need to solve for X and get rid of them. He like, can you say that again? He like, rewind. Y'all got sessions to go to. I need to finish up. Y'all gonna have me interrupting y'all sessions. I'll just come to y'all schools. We'll work it out, okay? Critical thinking. My own methodological formula is, if people do not add to you, they don't add to you and they subtract from you, always take it from you. Multiply your problems. When they come around, you just see a problem. You like, and they divide you from the one who created you. That went over all y'all here. You need to solve for that X, that unknown, and move some people around. Y'all ever play musical chairs? I'm dating myself. Y'all know how to sew, come on. And y'all got three chairs and four people. And everybody trying to break their neck to the third chair. Y'all need to move some chairs in your life. Y'all need to play a different song. Now, don't get me wrong, because I don't want nobody emailing my assistant, because y'all didn't say, well, Dr. Gill told me I don't need to hang around with you, because you ain't no good. Before y'all start cutting people off, I need you to critically think. The red, black, and green flag is in the spirit of what this conference is. The red is for the blood. If I was in church, that'd be a whole nother message. I'm a preacher too, sorry. They got a whole nother spirit in there. I just got to tell you all of who I am, because for the PhD, it was a G-O-D. But anyway, the black is for our unity. The black is for who we are as a people, our oneness. The green is for the land. Y'all should know that in the spirit of critical thinking, 400 years ago this year, we were, if you want to use 1619 as a landmark, we were brought to the shores in chains. 400 years ago. Now, one way to look at that is to think about the evil of a society that will relegate people that look like me and you to a space of enslavement. 400 years ago, the slaughter that was imparted upon our people, hung from trees. Don't let nobody tell your story for you. Read and know your story. Know what happened to you. Know what is going on in the world today. Critically think about some stuff. Think about why there's never been a black woman on the Supreme Court. Think about why there's only one sister in the whole United States Senate today. Think about why there are only two brothers, one on each side of the aisle. Think about how today, critically think about what's going on in your world and why it is people don't think you're equipped, you're ready. Think about how we can live here for so long and still had to utter 16 shots. Think about the fact that in your lifetime, you inherited a black president and the response to that. Think about a society that can look different. Think about a world that says, I can be the first black female Supreme Court justice. Think about a court that has only had two black men, one on the backs of Thurgood Marshall. Critically think about a world that has Fortune 500 companies, the richest companies, the most recognized countries in the index, in the business index today, with Walmart always leading. And think about how you can get on Facebook and none of their counsel looks like you. You can get on Twitter, you can get on Snapchat, but none of us created that. Go and do your homework. Look at the board of directors for Twitter and ask yourself why Facebook lacks so much diversity. Don't just, as I said, consume social media. Ask questions about social media. If I'm good enough to share an object, I'm good enough to sit on your board. Don't just share a video, make a new one. Critically think about how Dr. King was younger than all of y'all and was sick in his first year of college at that age. Think about how most of you are gonna graduate at 18 years old and Dr. King was already getting his bachelor's from Morehouse at 19. See, I don't talk about that part. How we come from a space and a spirit of innovators. I need you to think. I also need you to think about that formula I just gave you, because it takes one wrong decision, one wrong mistake for you to be with the wrong person at the wrong time and lose your whole life. This is serious business. This ain't a hashtag. This is your life. I need you to critically think about 400 years, but I wanna give you the positive side. I want you to think about how 400 years ago we came over here in chains, and 400 years later you got me with a PhD. I want you to think about your teachers and the degrees they have. Something about you can't keep us bound. And I want you to walk in the spirit of what it means to be around a Frederick Douglass, who even while he was enslaved, he decided slavery can't hold me. Harriet Tubman, she escaped the plantation because she knew her God said a plantation ain't for me. She can escape a plantation, you can't escape your friends? That ain't your friends? She can escape a plantation and you can't escape bad behavior? She can leave a plantation and you can't leave a block? I need you to critically think about one of my sheroes, Harriet, who said, you know what? I'm not only gonna fire freedom, I'm gonna go back and get my people and bring them too. I want you to think about our selfishness. How some of us would have been like, I'm free, they can find it on their own. I need some selfless people. When I first started my company, Blackademically Speaking, I had my colleagues like, you sure you don't want to work at Yale? You know, you could work at Brown. I'm like, yeah, but I'm brown. I got to go where my people are. I'm on a mission because I believe in you. But I need you to believe in you. That's why I'm here today, because I'm not going to just study you. I'm going to empower you. My degree allows me to study the ramifications and the praxis as a methodology. But my call says, when you finish writing, go teach. I need you to just critically think about who you are. And here's a word that I can spend some time on, but we're running out of time. She like, spend your time, girl, we'll get there. I'll come to y'all schools, we're gonna work it out. Character, say it.
Character.
Say it.
Character.
Character, ho, here we go. Y'all know what that is. Y'all know what it is. I need your character to be one where you rise above cyberbullying. Stop sharing stuff that don't look like integrity. I'm gonna come back to that. Everything thing ain't funny. People are watching you. There's really somebody watching you too. Cyberbullying. You're bigger than that. Today's premise is everybody got a story. So I think about me being epileptic. I'm gonna bring this home. And what if social media was out then? They would have cyberbullied me. Maybe. Look at what I became. So you're going to cyberbully, you're gonna get online and talk about somebody because they different, and you never know where they supposed to be on the other side. I need you to critically think before you post that next post, before you LOL, before you SMH, before you do all that. I need you to ask yourself some critical questions. Number one, is it true? Number two, is it kind? Number three, is it necessary? I'm gonna give it to you because none of y'all write that, because you're gonna need to remember that. Number one, is what I'm about to do true? Is it kind and is it necessary? Don't come to me saying, Dr. Gilbert, it was true and it wasn't kind. You have to answer all three. I'm about to share a video about somebody being beat up. Is this true? Is it kind? And is it necessary? The problem with your generation is you get the chance to freelance impulse. I ain't got time. You get to freelance impulse. You know how many grown people in this room thought about something and then had to go pray about it before they did it? Kiki, I'm just trying to say, we ain't always been smart. Thank God we didn't have Twitter, because we probably wouldn't have our jobs. You gotta think. Everything that's impulsive isn't productive. You gotta get off of social media. How you do it is what you do on your own. I'm not that adult that's gonna come and say it ain't nothing. You can build your brand on social media. Don't dilute your African-American brand. Conflict resolution. Too many of you guys, y'all know this to be real. We don't know how to talk stuff out. We get mad and we just get mad. I dare you to go to work like that. I'm just mad. Okay, go calm down. You gotta get paid. You might as well practice that now. Thank you so much. You may as well practice that now. Conflict resolution. These lights are hot. Conflict resolution. What is it that makes you so angry? Why are you so angry for who this is for? Conflict resolution. You ain't, everything ain't an argument. Well, she slapped me, she shouldn't have did this. She tapped me on my foot. She ain't have to say that to me. Ugh. Conflict resolution. Learn healthy communication. Get your spirit right. Get your heart right. And then I dare you to have courage. It took courage for me to leave the hood. Because everybody was there. They called me lame then. Today they called me for a job. I was valedictorian in my eighth grade class. I was the nerd. I was homecoming queen and all that. I did my thing in high school. Went on to U of I, but I was epileptic. I had the courage. I need some students in here to leave today saying, you know what, I heard Dr. Gill. Go home and shock your mama. She'll be like, girl, what happened to you, girl? What is wrong, girl? My daughter came home and studied. I need you to go home and hug your parents and have them to say, what's going on, honey? And I need you to say, I heard a speaker this morning, and I want to be a neurosurgeon, so I looked up Dr. Daniel, I'm gonna let you finish the last name, because he was one of the first people, not the first black people, one of the first human beings, some say the first, to perform open heart surgery right in the city of Chicago in Hat Park. I need you to say, if you say you wanna be it, let me see it. Don't wait to become a lawyer, get in the mirror in the morning and say, I am an attorney. Use your cousins as jurors and say, sit down, y'all, and start practicing. Had the courage to be different. Have compassion. Y'all need to learn how to love each other. Newsflash. Y'all gonna look the same in front of a company that's interviewing you. How you gonna get mad at your sister when the company interview, you're just gonna see two black sisters? How you gonna be mad at her? I'm gonna bring it home a different way. When I graduated with my PhD, that year was only a few hundred people in the country that had a PhD that looked like me. Y'all missed that, few hundred people. I ain't got time to be mad at you. We got work to do together. I'm compassionate. I know your story. And even if I don't, you're human. I need some humanity. We got enough inhumanity in the world right now today. We got enough people thinking it's okay to just say whatever and hurt people. I need some humanity today. Commitment. Stay committed. Raise your hand if you're an athlete. Commitment. Commitment is staying the course. But watch this. Who knows what tanking is? What is tanking in sports? Don't be scared, y'all. I'm not going. They looking like, well, I ain't gonna say it. I think I know, but she ain't ready to embarrass me. She used too many big words. What? What's tanking? Okay, in essence of time, Mr. Swope. Tanking is, like, say for the Miami Dolphins in football right now. They don't want to win on purpose because the goal is to try to get the number one pick next year. Sorry for their luck, they might not even get it. They doing all this losing to try to win the number one pick. Make sense? So teams will lose. They will spend the whole season losing on purpose because in sports, the more you lose, the more chance you have to get the number one pick. That's how the Bulls got D. Rose, but they had to lose first. And it don't always work like that. So I need you to be committed. What's my point? Stop taking your life. Stop losing. Stop accepting losing as an option. Mediocrity ain't a good look. I'm tired of hearing students, I say, how are your grades? They say, good, Doc, what's good? See, that ain't good, that's average. Can I talk to you? I know y'all looking like, but I got a C in physics though, it's honors. That's really like a B. I know how y'all are. But if I just get a C, that's like a B, carry the 2, divide the 1, I still got a 3.9, what? I need you to be committed to excellence. People say, well, Dr. Gill, I can't be perfect. I didn't ask you to, but you can be excellent. You can be excellent. Rosa Parks was excellent. When she sat on the, that was excellence. She didn't swing on the driver and the police officer. She left with dignity. The next scene is what? Bullshit. What? Bullshit. Say it again. Bullshit. If you don't do it for nothing else, then wrapping up. I need you to do it for the culture. I need you to leave here knowing that there was a Malcolm X, there was a Benjamin Banneker, there was a George Washington Carver, there was a Carter G. Woodson, there was a Sojourner Truth, there was a Mary McLeod Bethune. And if Mary McLeod Bethune all those years ago can start a school with 11 students and now have a university, tell me you can't start a business and create something bigger. I'm saying to you what I tell people all around the country, when people ask me to come and speak, well, why do you focus on Chicago now? Because if I'm living in a city that can build tall buildings, I can build some minds. And what I want you to know is if the city has the audacity to build buildings that are high, I can build your mind even higher. I need you to do it for the culture. I do it for Sadie T.M. Alexander, the first president of my sorority, because she was one of the first black women to get a PhD in America. Two of the first three black women were Deltas, my sorority. And so that's one of my sheroes, because she was the first, I hear you, she was one of the first to actually get a PhD. Who's your shero? Do it for the culture. Do it for DuSable, as I tell my little sixth graders in Chicago. Don't stand on the corner if you don't own it. Do it for the culture. DuSable was a brother who was the first settler in Chicago. He made money all those years ago. Why we living in poverty and the black man created this? He settled here first. So I need you to hide behind the culture. I need you to have some honesty in your life with a dose of integrity in your life, a pound of dignity in your life, and I need you to move in excellence. I need you to hide behind the culture. I need you to hide behind the culture and say, you know what? Real talk, if Harriet was alive, I'd be doing her a disservice. I don't look right. I got you. I'm coming back and say it again. I got it. Honesty. Integrity. Dignity and excellence. If my mama was here, she'll say, somehow along the way, we lost our way. We stopped having dignity. My grandma, may she rest in peace, who passed away this year, by the way, they used to say, if you only got two pair of pants, make sure they clean, ironed. And I always wonder, students, how we had so little those years ago and did so much, and how today we got so much and we do so little. You got access to so much. The same phone I use to make a call to do business is the same phone you can use to cyberbully. Same product, different mindset behind the product. Hide behind the culture. So I'm gonna give you what I give my sixth graders so we can start ending up. When I say I am, you say,
great.
I am.
Great.
I am.
Great.
I am.
Great.
Y'all don't believe it, huh? I'm on over here. I am.
Great.
I am.
Great.
I am.
Great.
When I say you are, you say even greater. You are.
Even greater.
You are.
Even greater.
Man, y'all sound. I am.
Great.
I am.
Great.
I am.
Great.
I am.
Great.
You are.
Even greater.
You are.
Even greater.
You are.
Then
I'm gonna say, together we are. You're gonna say, oh, come on now, we stumbling on the words now. They're gonna be messing up my video. I am.
Great.
I am.
Great.
I am.
Great.
You are.
Great.
You are.
Great.
You are.
Great.
Together we are.
Great.
Together we are.
Great.
Together we are.
Great.
I am.
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 Great.
I am. You are.
Great.
You are. You are.
Together we are.
Together we are. Together we are. The question is, what do you see? Don't go by what others say about you if it's not adding value to you. You got a whole lot more in you than you understand. You just gotta push yourself and stay committed. You gotta believe in college and career readiness, with the operative word being ready. We gotta get ready. We gotta be ready. You can't just show up. You gotta stay ready. You gotta study. You gotta read. Every day, you're creating what your obituary will read. And if you left today, what would people say about you? I want you to critically think about your life. It was an old song my daddy used to say, may he rest in peace. Daddy used to say, I'll always love my mama. You only get one, you only get one. I end today letting you know you only get one life. Don't waste it. Don't treat time as an inevitable commodity. You don't know when that year on the other side of the hyphen will occur. Every day, grace gives you another chance to do it right. Every day you get up and put your feet on the floor and you're vertical, you got a chance to do it right. Don't waste your time. Critically think. Have character. It does my heart good for Mr. Swope to get up here and not talk about my degrees and all that. The word that stands out to me is integrity. I'm a woman of my word. I run a company. I don't show up late, I get there early. I was here at 8, 7:45 if you count the time I was lost outside. Stop showing up late. Get there early. Do it for the culture, but also do it for that last name you got. Some grandmamas pray for you. Some parents are praying for you. They're at work right now pushing for you. Teachers are sacrificing because they see the bigger picture. They see the bureaucracy at place. They're doing it for you. Little Rock 9, those 9 students, they did it for you. They went to school in Central High School in Little Rock, Arkansas. Ruby Bridges, she did it for you. Dr. King said, I know I ain't gonna get that with you. He passed the baton. Now I need you to finish the race. How you look dropping the baton? How you drop the baton, Dr. Gill? Easy. Wasting time. Every time you go home and get on Twitter or Snapchat, every time you spend 2 hours texting, be careful of what controls you. Ain't it funny how you can pick up a device to control it and it end up controlling you? Hide behind the culture. The culture that somehow escaped slavery. Not because the masters got up one day and say, okay, cool, you can walk. No, because Nat Turner said, I'm gonna fight for my freedom. Because Frederick Douglass said, who you think you are can't tell me how to read. Imagine being on a plantation and teaching yourself how to read. And now you got a whole family and friends, set of friends that know how to read. That didn't just come because somebody liked you. Somebody fought for you. They fought for your right to vote. Obama didn't just happen. People died for that, white and black alike. Latino, Puerto Rican, Chicano, Mexicano, we are all in this together. I need you to be thinking. I need you to do it for the culture. And I need you to do it as my book says. I need you to be a champion and break chains. You ain't got to break chains off your ankles no more. They fooled you. You now got to break them off your mind. You got to break those chains on your mind that keeps you from reading ingredients on the back of food and eating it anyway. If you can't pronounce it, you might want to ask yourself if you should eat it. Champions break chains. Dr. Gill, how long you been vegan? 15 years. Well, wait, hold on, Doc, hold on, remix that. What you talking about? 15 years, before I became popular, I was doing this in college. But guess what the takeaway is? I ain't had a seizure since. I ain't had medicine since. Break chains. If you can't read it, you might not want to eat it. Don't wait till you think you're going to turn 30. Take care of your liver now. Take care of your kidneys now. Heart disease is number one in America right now, and that ain't got no discriminatory evidence. That's white, black, everybody. It's number one in this country. Diabetes is on the rise. Alzheimer's is on the rise. And guess what the good news is? The cure for it is sitting right here before me. You're the cure. Not only because you're going to change your habits, but because you're going to create the cure. I believe in you. So when I say champions, you say break chains. Champions.
Break
champions.
Break
champions.
Break
champions.
Break
I'm going to see who remember because I got to go now. I am.
Break.
I am.
Break.
You are.
Break.
Y'all sound a little weak. I got to let y'all go to y'all session. So y'all got to give me a little life. I am.
Break.
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 Y'all can't have me bringing more energy. Sit up. Do it for the culture. Sit up. Stop leaning. Do it. Have some dignity. Get your posture in order. I'm going to start over here like a choir. I am.
Great.
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 You are.
Great.
You are.
Great.
You are.
Great.
You are.
Great.
I am.
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 Great.
You are.
Great.
You are.
Great.
You are.
Great.
Together we are.
Great.
Together we are.
Champions.
What do you see? I got to get out of here.